Good morning and welcome to the morning halter classes. We'd like to call in the first class, and that is class 45, C45, the full futurity stallion junior. Thank you. This class is being sponsored by Penwood Percherons, Chad and Rhonda Cole in Center Hall, Pennsylvania. For over 30 years, Penwood's Percherons, owned by the Cole family, has bred and shown Percheron hitch and halter horses. They currently own around 50 head of primarily black breeding stock and show horses. Penwood's Percherons also stand several top Percheron stallions and ships semen all over North America. The Cole family also owns Penwood's equine products, specializing in specialty equine supplements.
Thank you.
like to, at this time, offer a round of applause for all these fine exhibitors and their animals. In first place, we have entry number 246, Windermere's Kassar. Rolling Hills Nature Boy, Windermere's Gerald Allenbach, Windermere Farms. In second place, entry number 119, that's Ryan Berger, Berger Percherons. In third, we have entry number 117, High Caliber Cliffhanger, Lynn Talene, High Caliber Farm. In fourth, entry number 114, the entry by Heidi Johnson at DJD Percherons. In fifth, 106, Anderson's Camelot, David Anderson, Anderson Farms. In sixth, we have entry 105, CRF Vito, Chase Fulton. In seventh, we have entry number 432, FF Edgar, Gary Fedor, Fedor Farm Percherons. In eighth, we have entry number 103, DLF Loomis, Brooke Vanderhunting, Dutch Love Farm. And in ninth, we have entry number 121, Hires Ringo, Stephanie Heyer, Heyer Farms, and Stefan Dittmar.
It could have been a suicide. 20 bullets in the back, boy, it happens all the time. I didn't kill her, I didn't do it. It could have been an accident.
We're now ready for class 46, the C46, the Full Security Stallion Senior Division. We'd like to ask that all exhibitors make sure you have the correct number
you can ask my brother, man,
for your class.
I didn't kill her, I didn't do it. If you're gonna accuse me, well, you better well prove it. Didn't kill her, I didn't do it. Oh, I didn't do it. Oh, I didn't do it. Oh, I didn't do it. There ain't no blood on my hands. Why you asking me, dude? 'Cause you got the wrong man. I didn't kill her, I didn't do it. You say my motive wasn't money. You pathetic little weasel, I've never been that cunning. Didn't kill her, I didn't do it. Could have been the government. Well, they murdered down in Waco and again at Ruby Ridge. I didn't kill her, I didn't do it. If you're gonna accuse me, well, you better well prove it. Didn't kill her, I didn't do it. Oh, I didn't do it. Oh, I didn't do it. Oh, me, man. Oh, no, I didn't do it.
We'll be right back.
Before we announce the winner, we'd like to express our appreciation once again to Pinwood Percherons for their sponsorship of both the junior and senior stallion class. In first place, we have entry number 123, Sandal Sterling, Dale and Sandy Berger. In second place, we have entry number 124, Anderson's Lemon, David Anderson, Anderson Farms. In third place, we have entry number 129, Bellevue Silky Smooth, Doyle Dingman, Bellevue Percherons. In fourth place, we have entry number 131, High Caliber Raucous Tumult, Lynn Talene, High Caliber Farm. In fifth place, we have VP Tundra, entry number 134, Ryan Berger, Berger Percherons. In sixth place, we have entry number 125, Hires Rutger, Stephanie Heyer, Heyer Farms, and Stefan Denmark.
Thank you.
winner in Class 47, the Full Futurity Philly Junior Division, is entry number 217, Tradewinds Horoscope, Amy Fry, Tradewinds Farm. In second place is entry number 438, Zubrod's Hope, Chad Zubrod, Zubrod's Percheron. In third place, entry number 221, DKW Crystals Kiss, Dean and Kelly Woodbury, Clear Creek Connection. In fourth place, entry number 238, Glenview Autumn, Tim and Linda Klinger, Glenview Percherons. In fifth place, number 219, Scenic View Brook, Bruce Heyer, Scenic View Percherons. And in sixth place, 433, Fisher's Arabella, Matthew Fisher, Fisher Family Percherons. We're now ready for Class 48, the Full Futurity Philly Senior Division. And we're looking for seven entries, Robert. At this time, we would like to acknowledge and introduce our judges for this morning. Our first judge is Mr. Glenn Lewis from Springfield, Missouri. Glenn, raise your hands, wave to the crowd. Glenn Lewis. Or not. Our second judge is Mr. Randy Robertson from Douro-Dumour, Ontario, Canada. Please express your appreciation for their service this morning. Our fearless ring man is Mr. Robert Sparrow from Ullman, Missouri. Thank you. At this time, we would like to express our appreciation to the sponsors of both the Philly classes today, and that is the All-Star Farms, sponsoring both the junior and senior division. Once again, we'd like to express our appreciation to our sponsors of the Philly, both the Philly divisions, the All-Star Farms, Nick and Sherry Wagner from Wayne, Ohio. Thank you so much to them for sponsoring, making this very, very possible for us this morning. Class 48, the Colt University of Philly Senior Division. The winner of this class is QB number 437, Zubrod's Autumn. Chad Zubrod, Zubrod's Percheron. In second place, entry number 256, BMX Xfinity, Ryan Berger, Berger Percheron, Beth Berger, and family. In third place, we have entry number 246, FP Impulse. Gerald Alabach, Windermere Farms. In fourth place, we have entry number 255, Lanes and Ruby, Robert Detweiler, Lanes and Farms. In fifth place, entry number 244, Lukasha Mirage, Freeman Yoder, Yoder Equine Stables. In sixth, we have entry number 249, Perlin Hannah. Last in seventh, we have entry number 245, FM Constance, Gary Fedor, Fedor Farm Percheron. Congratulations to all the exhibitors and their animals. We're now ready for Class 49, the Everglow 2-year-old Jackpot Halter Class, Division C. This class is being sponsored by Nature's Wave Everglow, Eli Ebersol, Ken Cox, and Steve Zayer, Milverton, Ontario, Canada. class in that it's really in two parts. 50% of the jackpot will be established as a result of the Holman class today, and then the same individual horses will compete in the cart class for the other 50% of the jackpot, and then based on those rankings, the winner will be announced later this week, the Supreme 2-year-old winner. Something else about this, these individual horses had to be entered by December 1 of 2016, and then by October of 2018, each individual animal must have been registered in the name of the competitor. We'll be right back. call out your number, please go to your left and circle around. There'll be ribbons for the first 10 slots, but we will announce all winners and all placings. In first place is entry number 299, DC Kelsey, Ryan Berger, Berger Percheron. Second place, entry number 177, DKW Crystal Cricket, Dean and Kelly Woodbury, Clear Creek Connection. In third is entry number 300, Lanes in Korea, Ryan Berger, Berger Percherons. Our fourth place winner is number 298, All Stars. Wagner All-Star Farms. Our fifth place winner is number 176, Trade Lance Marvel, Amy Fry, Trade Lance Farms. Placing sixth is number 283, Zubrod Electra, Chad Zubrod, Zubrod First Run. In seventh, entry number 156, Windermere's Crow, Gerald Alabach, Windermere Farms. In eighth, number 288, Bellevue Sapphire, Doyle Dingman, Bellevue Percheron. In ninth place, number 287, Keeley's Athena, Team Keeley, Keeley's Percheron. Tenth goes to entry number 291, Lone Oak 16, Carmen, Jim Lane, Lone Oak, Percheron. 11th place, entry number 425, Jeff and Diana Witt, entry. 12th goes to entry number 158, Alpine Valley Price, Ryan Pimentel, Central Valley, Percheron. 13th goes to 426, Kerwin Captain, Jim Kerwin, Kerwin Percheron. 14th, entry number 303, Hires Paola, Stephanie Hire, Hire Farms, Stefan Detmark. In 15th, entry number 292, Blackbrook Bella, John Jess Josephson, Blackbrook Percheron. Windermere's Black Pearl, Sharon Lee, Winter Night Percheron. Placing 17, number 442, Windermere's Helga, Sharon Lee, Winter Night Percheron. In 18, entry number 153, F.F. Vander, Gary Fedor, Fedor Farm Percheron. 19, number 293, Anderson Beyonce, John or Terry Myron, Killer's Journey Farm. And in 20th spot, 297, Marker's Moonlight Madness, Mark Cook, Mark R. Farms. Attention in the barns, there will be a 45-minute break before we start the four abreast hitch. 45-minute break.
Ladies and gentlemen, we'd like to welcome you to our mid-morning performance. We are going to be bringing our four abreast classes into the arena. What a fun class, not a class that's offered at many of the shows and events. Here at the World Percheron Congress, we are going to have 9 entries in our four abreast. We are welcoming into the arena Mr. Steve Gregg, joining us from Cargill, Ontario, Canada. Steve is going to be officiating. He is going to be working with Mr. Justin Carey in the arena as our ring steward. Also, Ken Seams, our official photographer, capturing the memories and the moments of the World Percheron Congress. These gentlemen are in the arena. Our crews on the outside have assured us that our first division is ready to go. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome our four abreast into the arena. One more entry for this division. Our final entry now entering the arena. As the gates close, drivers on the rail at the trot. For those of you watching, we do want you to step off of the rail. We don't want to scare any of the horses, so off of the rail. At the trot, please. And Jimmy, you are going to start our reverse when you get down to Justin, please, reversing in the corner. Watch our drivers as they turn these four abreast around in the corner. They are going to make that diagonal cut just as we did in the standard classes, the four abreast. What a beautiful class to be highlighted here in the Jacobson Center. Down to the walk. Drivers, walk please. And trot on please. Back into the trot. Thank you. And we are going to be lining up. Jim, you'll start our lineup as you make your way around. Would you give them a nice round of applause, a beautiful display of our four abreast, the first division now in the arena. Our judge, Mr. Steve Gregg, making his way around each entry. As I said, this class is split into two divisions. We will have everybody back in for the final judging, but our first four entries for the four abreast now working for our judge. Our judge, Mr. Gregg, has now seen all the entries in the first division. We are going to be opening the gates. Dean, if you would make your way out to the right. We are going to dismiss this section. What a fun class, ladies and gentlemen. Give them all a round of applause as they make their way out in the four abreast first division. We would like to say a special thank you to Shining Stars Percherons, Diana Marcourt and crew from Altoona, Iowa, sponsoring our Open Four Abreast. Our afternoon performance will start at 1 o'clock today. In the middle of our times, we do invite you to go to the vendor barn. We do have a concession stand for the food as well over there. But we do have plenty of vendors selling everything from clothing to jewelry, campers, wooden home decor, everything that you can imagine for the draft horse industry. That is directly across from the horse barn in what we normally would have as the beef barn. Next into the arena, the final cut to our four abreast. We're looking for five entries.
I'm not the one.
In this division, we will have five entries competing for our judges' attention. And our final entry coming through the gates, on the rail at the trot drivers, on the rail at the trot. And beginning with the messenger entry, Brian, you are going to start our reverse. Down to the walk, please. Down to the walk. And trot on, please. Trot on. Beginning with the messengers, we will be lining up as you make your way around. Drivers pulling in as closely but as safely as possible. Well, ladies and gentlemen, another fast-paced class making their way into the lineup, a beautiful display of the four abreast. Would you give them a nice round of applause? Our first group coming back into the lineup. We'll have all nine entries in. It will be wall to wall of our four abreast as our drivers come back from both divisions for our final placings. Our judge, Mr. Steve Gregg, has now seen all of the entries in the four abreast class. As I said, this is a class that is not provided at many of our shows. Number one, because of the size. And if you remember going to those shows in Florida in the 90s, the judge and I were just reminiscing about the first time we hooked the four abreast there, the gate wasn't big enough, and we had to reconstruct the gate to get these hitches in. So not a lot of shows have an accommodation for the four abreast, but here at the World Percheron Congress, it truly has been one of our class favorites for the spectators. You will see all of our drivers are kind of driving in a different formation. Some drivers have four of the lines in their hand, just like driving each individual horse. Some of the drivers only have two lines. They have paired off these horses and only driving with two lines. It is totally whatever they are comfortable with. This class originated in the days of horsepower with the farming. You will most notably always see, even in modern times with the Amish, the four abreast and the four horses wide doing the work. It was not a hitch that was very prevalent in the towns because the streets were always very narrow and the four abreast would have taken up way too much of the space on the streets. It was primarily used in the farming industry, and now today in the show arena, it is being brought back to life. A piece of our American history being brought back with our very talented drivers. It can be a difficult class, as you can see. Our judge always looking to make sure those four horses are even, that one or more of the horses is not trying to outdo the other horse. It is a hitch that is not very common for these hitch horses. So it is a class that takes a lot of concentration by our drivers, and our judge will be making our final decision. We do want to remind everyone, if you have a vehicle parked around the barns, they must be moved for our afternoon show. There's plenty of parking directly to the outside of this arena, but when we come to those multiple hitches, we have to have all of the cars moved from around the barn area. Also, we want to remind you that our vendor area is open. Make sure to stop by and shop and take home your souvenirs and memorabilia from the World Percheron Congress. We will be back in the arena at 1 o'clock. We will take a break following this class until 1 o'clock. At this time, ladies and gentlemen, we are welcoming our royalty into the arena. We have your World Percheron Congress Queen, Jolene Yoder, as well as Kenseth, our World Percheron Congress Princess, to help make the awards presentation. In ninth place today, ninth place is going to entry 618. That is the entry of Lone Oak Percherons of Bertle, Manitoba. Mr. Jim Lane doing the driving. Coming a long way from the province of Manitoba. In eighth place, number 625, that is the entry of the Hammersbach Percherons of Wisconsin, Scott Sanders and Lori up on the seat. In seventh place today, the honors will go to number 627. That is the entry of the Pittman family, Pittman Percherons of Claremont, Minnesota. Mark doing the driving. In sixth place, we're going to call out number 623. That is Charles Wood Percherons of Pilot Mound, Manitoba. That is the entry driven today by Mr. Kent Anderson. Our fifth place award is going to number 624. That is the entry of the Mark Messenger Memorial Hitch from Cheyenne, Wyoming, under the control of Mr. Brian Coleman. In fourth place, entry number 614, that is the entry of Shining Stars Percherons from Pleasant Hill, Iowa, Jared Hansen on the lines. We are making some adjustments over there, so we'll hold up just a moment. Coming up for their award now, the entry of Mark Messenger Memorial Hitch. That is your fifth place award today. Fourth place again, going to Shining Stars Percherons. In third place, the honors to number 602. That is the entry of Zubrod Percherons of Guthrie, Oklahoma. Dr. Chad Zubrod and his wife Melissa. The parents of our beautiful Percheron Princess Kenseth. In second place today, we're going to send the award to Plainview, Minnesota with the Schreiber Perch Friends. Brad Schreiber doing the driving, number 611. Congratulations. And capturing your world title in our open four abreast class, entry number 601. That is the entry of the Blue Ribbon Days. That is the entry driven today by Mr. Dean Woodbury. His accompaniment, Mr. Stefan Dittenmar, joining us from Germany. This is a combined hitch owned by the Cleaveys, the Days, and the Dittmars. They are coming around for their World Champion Trophy. We do want to again thank Shining Star Perchrens, Diana Marcourt, and her group from Shining Star. So happily sponsoring our Open Four Abreast competition. The world title now going home with the Blue Ribbon Days. The Bells of Blue Ribbon. Stefan Dittenmar accepting the award on behalf of the Blue Ribbon Days. Crowning our first world champion of the day. Round two, day number two of our World Perchrens Congress. Dean Woodbury on the lines. And again, our thank you going out to Shining Stars Perchrens. Well, Stefan, what a nice day to start the show with a blue ribbon and a champion, world champion honors. As they make their way around, ladies and gentlemen, our congratulations once again. Your world champion four abreast, the entry of the Blue Ribbon Days, Mr. Dean Woodbury on the lines. Your world champion, four abreast, the Blue Ribbon Days entry. Up on this seat, Mr. Dean Woodbury and Stefan Dittenmar. Congratulations. Well, ladies and gentlemen, so nice to see so many of you joining us today. We are going to be asking that you find your way through the barns, visiting our exhibitors, taking time to visit all of those in the vendor area. We do have our food vendor open in the cattle barn. And we hope you enjoy your day visiting our Perchrens and the Perchren exhibitors. If you could have a representative